Performance Mic with Monkey Fab. I'm going to put together a 3D printer today that I got from my friend Chris Bennett at Tiny Machines. So I'm pretty excited about this. It's going to let me print some stuff up. I think it'll be good to have prototype and stuff and see if we can develop that prototype and then cut it out 3D, cut out plasma, assemble it, and install on things. So that's why I got it, and I'm pretty excited about it. Real good deal. And I'm just going to kind of go through it the best I can and try to make a video at the end that's kind of hopefully cogent and able to use, you know, people will be able to use that. So here we go. Got this cool box, and here it is tinymachine.com. He needs a bigger logo. Where to stab here. And the cool thing is he's got like a quick assembly video on his website that's done really well, and it's edited. I hope I'm not killing anything. It's edited, it kind of just like blows through it, like fast forwards the stuff, and you don't have to suffer there with all the nuts and bolts and turning and stumbling over directions. So you can go to tinymachines.com, tinymachines3d.com, and just follow along in this installation video. But if you want to see how a monkey does it, you can hang out here. So let's see. Stuff has got to come out. How do we do this? Just pull it all the way out. It's pretty nice. It looks pretty nice. What I'm going to do, I think, is open up his website and play it to kind of follow along with. Oh, my friend's on order. This is the control unit. It's pretty cool. Really nicely packaged, a lot of styrofoam stuff to keep everything from getting damaged. I'm no expert on this stuff, to be quite honest. I have never 3D printed a single thing in my life. I've only fondled them. So this is kind of the gantry, it looks like, and it's all extruded aluminum. Pretty cool stuff. It looks nice. Roller bearings. Am I missing anything? Probably fucking up. So this is the box that came in. All this foam packing stuff. Yeah, that's it. Okay. So we'll throw this over here. Out of the way. Bam! This here, tape, I don't know what the tape's about. Somebody knows. Oh yeah, that's all I'm gonna do is open up. Okay, just Google search tiny machines, go to the website, our mission, yada yada yada, links, CR10 assembly video. We'll turn the volume down. Got stuff in here, power cords, that'll probably come last. handle thingy. Something. Probably for the spool, I'm guessing. Weird little wire thing. Alright. Guessing instructions. Zip ties, clippers, little machine stuff, little nuts and bolts, some weird little thing. Don't know what that's about. Metal stuff. USB cable. Gantry parts, wire or plastic, little collet, looks like a USB port, and some more plastic. Alright, so I tend to trail off when I have no idea what's going on, so that's why my volume will fluctuate. Okay, so gotta take this out. Okay, set that down. Try to clear off a bit of workspace. I think these are the tools we're gonna use. I think everything's here that I need. As far as like, you know, tools go, which is nice because all my tools are outside in my shop and I don't want to be running back and forth doing that. So let's open this up. And we'll play the instructional video. Alright, so this is open. Doing next, I'm gonna follow along in the video. Check out the QC sheet. Yeah, we got one of those. Okay, so this comes off. Does it come off? How does this do it? How does this thing just turn over? I guess that stays on. And we turn this over. So I did clean this table off, just to make sure we weren't getting any boogers on the table. Okay, so adjust these guys to make it move. Adjusting these wheels right here, and is it clockwise, counterclockwise, oh, interesting. Button head bolt on them, and that's not it. This guy, and what I'm gonna do is just try to mess with one side. And I think I'll probably just my torch mate kind of has a similar set of ball bearings where they're just. Basically nuts in the slot. Man, I still haven't got it right. You're too tight. Okay, let's try it again. All you do is kind of play with it until you get the right resistance. us there. So it seems that two adjustment points, like there's a nut underneath these guys, underneath the roller right here, there's a nut and then there's a button head, and they seem to adjust independent of each other, so maybe it's not like just a slot. But we got it going, so that's good. So we're up to next on the video. There's a belt. Let me roll this down here. So there's a belt. Here. That has a little stepper motor. And that's what moves the table. With a little cogged belt. And it calls to make adjustments by undoing the nuts. I think that's necessary, so it's pretty tight. I'm gonna leave it how it is. Okay, so we're going to attach stuff to the base. What stuff are we attaching, you might ask? I don't know. Okay, so we're gonna lift the table up and turn it around. So here's the tightening adjustment point. It's funny because it's 3D printed. But anyway, you loosen these little bolts right here and then kind of pry here, and then tighten the bolts down to tighten your belt. But the belt came nice and tight. So I just ripped these out of the foam that was in here. I'm going to use this to kind of lift the table up so I can gain some access underneath it. I'm going to put one here, and I'm going to put one here. And good enough. We'll figure it out. I always do. Now we're going to attach the tower, and all you got to do is there's a couple bolt holes in the rail. Here, here, and on the opposite side as well. And all we're going to do is set the tower up right there so it can be attached. I need a little more stability than these little foam guys are going to offer. So we're going to throw this underneath here. There we go. Now we're stable. Put one on each side over here. Heavy editing on this one. Heavy editing is going to have to go down. Okay, so the little pack with some little T-joints and some socket head bolts with little lock nuts. So we just put the lock nuts on the socket head bolts. These guys are going to go through here and hold the tower in place. So going to figure out which one of these Allen heads we need so we're not searching for it. Once we get the tower put up, there we go. And there's, you'll notice on the base, there's a side with, it has a little plastic inserts on the aluminum extrusion for probably aesthetics. What we're going to do is one side's cut a little shorter on the plastic, so that's where this little stepper motor goes that drives the tower on the Z-axis. So just line this up, see if I can get it figured out. Right around, maybe there. A little trick, always turn the bolt counterclockwise first, so you hear it go click, and then start tightening it down. That'll keep you from going in a funny angle. Stripping stuff out. cool that with a little bit of patience, you can assemble this by yourself. So this is just going up there. Catch all those threads, this side. A little tight, but it goes in. Set these guys up. Got you because I can. Go down. I'm not going to slug them down all the way. I'm just going to give them that 95%. Once we know everything is solid and lined up well, we'll go ahead and slug them down all the way. And now we're going to slug them all down, put a little torque in it, so we go over here. So next we're going to put these little T-braces on, and that just braces the tower. And it's got little T-nuts in the back. And what I would do, what I'm going to do, is I'm going to back them out just a little bit. Make sure we can get past the extrusion. Because what happens is these extrusions are like channels. And these T-nuts are going to just go in there and then rotate and kind of lock in place as I snug it down. And we're going to need this guy. Nope. They got bigger. This one is that right? Yeah, that's it. Make sure it's not this guy. Just double check. No, not that guy. So I'm just gonna orientate the bolts like this. Doot 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 doot. You can see there. And it's just gonna pull, and then we're gonna tighten it down. Was easy. It's pretty cool. The side's got a little micro switch on it right here. It probably keeps your Z from crashing your machine. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. Super easy. They just want to go home. They want to go home. What's funny is I've been putting this off for like 2 weeks now. I've been thinking like, oh, I'm so busy. But man, this really isn't terribly complicated at all. And even following along the video, I probably could do this uncut, but somebody watching it would want to hang me. Uh-oh, my video. So, here we go. Tighten those guys down. That's a done deal. What next? Alright, so we're going to just set this back down on the ground. We're on the table. Feels pretty sturdy. Okay, so it calls to make adjustments on the gantry. Gonna call this the Y axis, this is the X axis, and this is the Z axis. So there's just, it's the same thing, there's a little nut in here that adjusts, and over here is an adjustment for the tension. All you have to do is unloosen these guys right here, just kind of put a little pry bar in there, or just one of these Allen keys would work fine, and snug them back down. But and then there's one here on the Z axis for the up and down. All my adjustments came good, so I mean it feels good, and I'm not going to touch it because there's no reason to fix something that's not broken. Okay, so we're going to plug in the power control unit. It has like a little harness coming off that's all labeled, so you can follow along in the video. It's pretty well done and explains well how to do that. But I'm going to give it a shot by just going with what the plugs say on the end and see what happens. So we got here, we got Y, and X, and Z, and E. So I think we're supposed to be on this side of the table, because that's where these plugs are. Two. So we'll scoop this over, put this here, and we'll try to figure this out. These guys, so there's only one way these guys can go because they're different. So the 4-pin will go on the 4-pin hole, obviously. And the 7-pin will go in the 7-pin or 6-pin, whatever it is. What else? It's got a little notch. The notch always goes up on these guys. Just give it a little worky work. And it zooms right in there, no problem. Alright. Power supply. Next, we plug in the power supply. It's just a regular computer CPU type plug. And do I have power over here? Yes. Yes. Right. Make sure all the cables are attached to the X motor. Limit switches are on top of all the other cables. Much because everything's loomed so nice. This is going to be going back and forth. So with that, it's going to this thing on. Okay, so it goes on. Spring comes on, 3D printer, we got this guy right here. Okay, test the limit switches by selecting auto home and prepare menu. Okay, so let's see, prepare. Go.
It's like mostly just a game.
Just bang into the limiters.
Yeah.
When they hit the micro switch, then they know they're at home.
Okay, so you gotta get it to temperature. Control. Temperature. Bed. Now we can see our nozzle and our bed warming up.
Oh yeah, it's getting there.
Okay, so we gotta do stuff now. Push this to...
Alright, so now we're on to pushing the tube.
Yeah, I should run this better. I'm gonna have to redo this when I get this thing finally set up. Push this in here. This is just a regular push lock, so that's easy enough. I'll be scooped in there nice and firm, make sure it's seated well.
The thumb screws just go into this guy here. Let's make sure I'm doing this right. So it kind of leans this way. The gangster lean is that way. So these little screws just go on top of your control box here. And here. And then, where did the black handle go? What's going on here? So that's probably for loading. This is not for loading. Let's see if we can figure it out without the video. The video. So that goes on to here. This goes on to the back. It screws down firmly. Oh yeah, that's not bad. And then that's where you load the wire. Smooth filament. Cut this off and make it nice and smooth. It's gotta be nice and smooth. So it's all boogered right there, so just snip it off is what it's telling us to do. Smooth, that wasn't smooth, Mike. There we go. Doesn't get much smoother than that. That was silky smooth. That was silky smooth. Getting ahead of me. Okay, so this goes in here. Should it go this way or the other way? I guess that works. So we'll just stick it in this hole. And there's like a little feed mechanism in there. Kind of like for your MIG welder. Where do you go? I want you going in the hole. Just
Oh, there we go. Now you're supposed to push this. There's leather hanging up. Come on. Come on. I'm going to do this. That is... There we go. Amazingly tight. I'm going to cheat and take this off, because I know that's what's going on. It's just hanging up. And I'm going to stick this through here like that. And shove that back in. Because cheating is what I'm good at. And then feed it through. So you fill it stop once more. It's supposed to be at the nozzle. So give it a little pushy push. Yeah, some goop coming out. Alright, must be doing something right. Tighten up the thumb screws under each corner. We'll bring the print surface down and away from the nozzle. So, I'm guessing there's little, yes, so there's little springs and things right here. You can bet probably semi-adjusted from like this, but we'll go ahead and mess with this anyway. So hand tight before starting the level. Okay. Damn it. With the nozzle and the bed still up to temperature, position the print head at the left corner of the printer bed. So we're already there. But the problem is I squeezed a bunch of goop out and now I got a big goopy under there, so don't know if there's a jog feature. There's got to be a jog feature on here. Let's see. Can we jog? Hey. Control. I'm going to say control. Motion. Probably. Z. It's the offset. So I don't know about doing offsets. I just want to jog. All this stuff looks complicated. I don't want to mess with it. Is there a jog feature? Let's go back to control, motion, LED contrast, fill state. Name, let's go to name. Prepare. Move axis, okay. Now we're getting somewhere. Move 10 millimeters, okay? Okay, let's move the... I'm gonna go up. Z-axis too. Oh, what are you doing, homie? Why'd you go home? I didn't want you to go home. Rapid. If
G00.
Okay, so it doesn't like to stay here. That's alright. Move axis, move 1 millimeter, and move the Z axis. So we're at 40, so let's go to 0. It's coming out of their boomers. Okay, so that's 0. Doesn't really look like 0 though. I go under, it does let you get less than. Alright. So let's go. Oh, that's what the bed's adjusting for. Alright. So we'll just get a piece of paper. Got this piece of paper, it's really nice. This will work. So I'm just going to fold it over and make a feeler gauge out of it. One through here is a little screws. And just loosen it. I'm loosening. I should be loosening the book as well. So it's little screws on it. I'm not dragging the nozzle across this axis as we go. There we go, that's it. Alright, so it's 180. Let's get this guy. That bed's kind of warm. I'm gonna go move 1 axis. I'm gonna lift up the Z so I'm not dragging it across. Then I'm gonna go back to the Y axis. Whoa, check that out! Yeah, Chris told me I needed a solid table. And I can see why now, because it actually rapids pretty quick. And then it stops, and then it makes the table go jerky jerk, and now it probably messed up. Move the Z back down. No. There's Z. And it probably messed stuff up. The table's all jerking around when you're trying to print something. Jog that over there, and then we'll do it again, because sometimes when you're doing stuff like this, it kind of changes all the Z axes, because you're adjusting just a little bit over here, go down to move axis, and we're in the 10, and we're in
the x-axis. Oh, so we got a zero. So we're SD card time. I don't know if I have an SD card. I got this guy. Is this an SD card? It is an SD card. And it's a USB. Wow, who knew? What kind of technology? What kind of witchcraft is this? So it goes in the back of the machine. It looked like it said, but I don't see a slot in the back. There's a side. Okay, so we're on the side. This even got a USB port over here. So upside down, stick it in. Info screen. I have to follow along. So what do I know about computers? You need to initialize the SD card, okay. So how do we do that, sir? By going to initialize SD card. Oh, you're too fast, you're too fast, you're too fast. SD card. Initialize SD card. Print from SD card, okay. Alright, so we go to initialize SD card, print from SD card. Alright. And DRC10. 4D models. One more. Alright, I hope this isn't a big program, but I think we're about ready to print, man. It's going down. Shit is going down. Okay, it says heating. I think it loaded the file, it says 100%, and maybe when the nozzle gets up to temp, it'll be ready to roll, maybe possibly. We got all kinds of like USB cable left over, and call it, there's all kinds of spare parts. I'm sure this is something to do with the heater element. This is a nice machine, it really is. It's got some zip ties. I was thinking about that. I was like, we should zip tie this guy up. Uh-oh, stuff's happening.